with sugar.
Okay, ladies, well, nice to meet you. I'm Helen.
Helen Milligan, stepping out. Cool.
Right, come on, let's go.
Calm.
Ladies, come on.
Collect it.
No, you're definitely finishing it. We're not leaving a client with half the rubbish still.
And comfortable in the corporate world.
We will go with that one. I'm experienced with managing large teams. I'm experienced with organising people. Where I feel like I could bring a lot to it is organising the team well.
From the start, she made her mission clear.
My social life, my personal life don't mean anything to me. Work and business are my whole life. I live to work, that's all I do.
But for the first five tasks, she kept a low profile.
I hope we haven't left getting the pasta out too late. Would you like to try our hot vegetable pasta? We made it ourselves this morning.
Not particularly.
All right, okay. Okay. Thank you.
Helen had a fairly easy ride. She was on the winning team, but she was always scudding around in the shrubbery in the background, not actually doing anything too much.
Helen was a shy child.
I thought she was almost slightly too introverted. So, in fact, my job was to try and to get out of that shell a little bit more.
I did hockey, netball, violin, ballet, tap, swimming.
But she came out of a shell, and I think that's made her slightly more rounded than if she'd just been a studious girl.
A top girl at school, it was on to a degree.
I did law at university. I did really well at it. I really enjoyed it. I got 2-1.
But the legal world didn't suit her.
When I was faced with actually being a solicitor, I didn't want to defend people that were mainly guilty. So I went back to doing the only thing I knew how to do, which was waitress. It was start work at midday, finish at 12 o'clock at night, and then go out afterwards.
She cut loose from her academic past.
When I first met Helen, people probably thought Helen was a bit of a bimbo, just merely on appearances, because she's very pretty. She always looked like a model. She always had the long blonde hair, and I think that they just assumed that she wouldn't be that intelligent, especially working as a waitress as well, because that sort of goes against you. But far from it, she's very clever and she knows how to look after herself.
Morning, Helen.
Hi.
But after waiting tables, her career took off. She moved into management, then regional management, and was finally headhunted to become an executive in the UK's biggest bakery chain.
Helen's role is absolutely critical. It requires a number of qualities, from being a great organiser, a great communicator, a great motivator, and somebody that can really make things happen. And Helen is absolutely fantastic at doing that.
I believe I'm one of the best employees a company could take on. I'm extremely loyal, I'm extremely hardworking, but now it's time for me to start my own business with Lord Sugar and start reaping some success for myself.
Week 6. Helen stepped out and into the rubbish task. Lord Sugar had shifted her to a losing team.
We're absolutely nailing this. I've won the last 5. I'm not losing one.
Without batting an eyelid, she took the lead.
What we really need to know is, what is it you want us to take away?
When is it you want us to do it?
She made the decision to not charge for our services.
Okay. I think then what we can offer you is we could clear away your general waste for you and there would be no charge for that.
I think that's not good business.
That was a risky strategy. Probably most people disagreed with me. But I felt very strongly that that's my tactic. I'm the project manager. It's my head that's on the line.
That's good.
I've written down everything, all the addresses. Just take this with you. 1240 Battersea, yeah?
Brilliant. Brilliant. Thank you. See you later.
We'll call you. Bye. See you guys.
Could she organise? Could she manage? Could she deliver?
Okay,
thank you very much.
She proved she could, and she did that with a team that had just lost a task and lost quite badly, so they were very demotivated, and she showed that she had the skills to give them that organisation that they were very lacking.
Helen, you've now been on a winning team 6 times, so you're like the lucky mascot, really.
She's grown in confidence. Previously, she's always been the kind of the mouse in the corner who whispers the very good advice to someone who then fronts it. I think she's realising from this process that actually she could be the person fronting it.
Well done, and a great win for Team Logic.
Yep.
Cheers.
Team Logic.
Bonjour.
Now into her stride, In Paris, Helen was pitch perfect.
We know your catalogue, we know your website. I've actually ordered from your catalogue before, so I was obviously really excited to come and pitch to you today because I think it would fit really well with the sort of the modern working woman.
She walked in there with the rucksack that was also a car seat, and she delivered a absolutely perfect pitch, so much so that she had them eating out of her hand.
With the modern woman now, we're all so busy. We'll pay anything for convenience.
You know, I've been in business a long time and it takes years of practicing pitches to deliver one as good as that.
You can say, we are the first people to bring this to friends. We care about you as our customers. We care about your children's safety. We know how busy you are and this is a great, convenient product for you.
Thanks, I have to say, to the fantastic pitch that Helen did of the backpack booster seat. They've placed an order of 214,000 euros, Alan.
Wow. That's a big one. Very, very good.
You did the manufacturer of that product proud. You represented him very well indeed. Well done.
Helen's head for business was evident early on.
I remember a time, I must have been about 6 or 7, so she was a couple of years older, and she knew how much pocket money I got every week, and she'd advertise in the house that she had a disco in a bedroom for my whole amount of pocket money for the week, make it sound really exciting, and I'd go into her bedroom and she'd play her music, flash the light on and off, and have me dancing around her room. So I knew then that she'd always get what she wanted, really.
Ellie Mae and Joshua, my niece and nephew, they're a great part of my life. They think at the moment, actually, that I'm away working on a new job. And Joshua's got it into his head that he thinks I'm a spy because he can't talk to me a lot. So he's absolutely convinced that I'm the female James Bond.
I do miss Auntie Helen. I might save up some pictures and then give her them when she comes back.
In week 9, Helen aimed for the stars.
We are Venture Biscuits. My name's Helen. Joshua would have really liked Special Star Biscuits because he always likes it when you say well done to him. He was a big influence on our choice of biscuits.
Nice.
Helen came up with the idea of Special Stars, the biscuits, which were absolutely phenomenal and a fantastic order. And it was her idea really from start to finish.
Again, boardroom records tumbled.
Helen, you have got yourself an order for 800,000 units. Unbelievable. I've never seen anything like that.
That takes the biscuit. I got you.
Helen, you haven't lost a task yet. I'm delighted, but what the...
With 9 out of 9 wins, Helen was flying high. But then, in Lord Sugar's reinvestment task, she came crashing down.
It started going wrong 10 minutes after we left the warehouse from choosing our goods. And I could feel it going further and further on a downward spiral.
Melody was team leader, but it was Helen who came up with the wrong plan.
We were thinking, would you like to take a bulk order from us in any way, save you a trip to your wholesaler, save delivery costs and so forth?
Helen's strategy in the reinvestment task was completely wrong.
Hi, Helen. How's it going?
It's not going brilliantly.
I found the linen wholesaler.
And they've closed at 2 o'clock.
Her idea was to put herself in between the retailer and the wholesaler. It didn't work. It wasn't a concept that was workable. She either didn't understand it or she didn't comprehend how to win it.
Helen tried to stop the rot with a bid for power.
Today, it needs really strong strategy, organisation. Is it best if I take over as project manager?
No to that, because actually I'm project manager and I want to take responsibility because that's what I put myself forward to do.
But the team's fate was sealed.
For the very first time when we went into the boardroom and she realised the mistakes that she had made, she was shocked.
Going off selling to wholesalers, selling to pound shops.
She was knocked off her perch a little bit.
It demolishes wins that you've had in me thinking this is the right person, and then suddenly the most simple principle of business and you make a big mistake.
And actually, she looked quite vulnerable.
Helen, this retail strategy was wrong. It was totally wrong.
Helen has always been composed. There is that side to her where she won't break at all. I've only seen her cry a couple of times. She's not cold-hearted or anything. She has her emotions, but she hides them well and she's very professional.
It is with regret, Melody, that you're fired.
Helen survived, just.
That was the most under pressure I felt.
The truth about Helen is she's got the best record, 9 wins and 1 loss. And in fact, the only question mark against her is why hasn't she set up her own business? What has she been waiting for? And can she? Can she actually physically go out and set up a business, have a great idea, and drive it forward?